A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. You had learned about some new options of the tools menu. So today you will practice the use of these options. Before we begin today's class, let us revise what you learned in the previous class. Do you know why the Goal Seek option is used? Whenever you need to change the target cell value with the help of some other cell, then you will need to use the Goal Seek option. Do you know why is the solver used? With the help of the solver, you can change the value of a cell from more than one row or column. Solver works on cell group. When you want to use more than one value with the defined value to complete the target value, then you use the solver. If you want to apply a password on your spreadsheet document, then how will you do this? If you want to apply a password on your spreadsheet document, then you will use the protect document option. What is the syntax to be used for left and right formulas? For left, the syntax is equal to left begin bracket, text within inverted commas, semicolon, and the number within and close the bracket. And for the right, the syntax is equal to right begin bracket, text within inverted commas, semicolon, number with close the bracket. Can you tell what is the difference between find and search formula? Using the find formula, you can look for a word or symbol in your text, but the word or symbol you are looking for must be exactly the same. The search formula can be used with words written in capitals or small letters or a mix, since this is not case sensitive. So with this formula, it is easier for you to find words or symbols in your text. Using the scenario option, what tasks can you do? If your data keeps constantly changing, then you will use the scenario option. This will help you to see your data as it was and also with the changes made on it. You can use the scenario option by defining and then using it one by one, and it will be shown to you as the border and by its name. Why is the mid formula used? If you want to define the number of characters that you want to show or that you want to see from the middle of a text, then you will apply the mid formula. Now, all of you switch on your computers and open the spreadsheet or the Calc file. Have you all opened your Calc or spreadsheet files? Now, all of you type in some data in your spreadsheet or look at the data given in front of you and key it in your sheet. Have you all typed in the data? Now, all of you show how you will extract the first three letters from a cell's name. And in case you face a problem, then watch the video. With the help of this video, we are going to now revise how we can use the left formula to show, say, three characters from the left side of any cell. So we type left as a title and then we use the left formula here, which is equal to left begin the bracket, then choose the text, which is the email ID. So we choose that, select that, put a semicolon, and then type the number of characters that you want to show. So if you want to show the first three characters from the left, we type 3, close the bracket and press enter, and you will see ARU is written here. So if you drag this down the formula, or if you double click on this black dot, then you can see that the from the other email IDs also the first three characters TAN and KUN are shown to you. Similarly, show how you will extract four words from the right side of any name. If you face a problem, then watch the video and understand how this is done. Watch this video now and practice how we use the right formula to extract the characters on the right side of any cell. So we will write the title right here, RIGHT, and then we use the formula equal to write RIGHT, begin the bracket, and then select the text from where you want to find the characters from the right side of the cell, which is the email ID. So we select that, put a semicolon, and the number of characters we want from the right side is 4. So we write 4, close the bracket, press enter, and you can see that the word com, it's actually dot com, is shown to us, which is 4 characters, dot and then C, O and M. If you drag this formula down or double click on the black dot, you will see that all the other email IDs also show you .com. So this is how you will use the right formula. Next, show how you will extract the central character from any word in a cell. If you have doubts about this, then watch the video. Let us now watch this video and practice the use of the mid formula. So if you want to find the characters in the middle of any cell, some characters in the middle, you will use the mid formula. For this we have typed mid as the title, and then we apply the formula. We want to find, let's say, Kumar out of this email ID arun.kumar@gmail.com. So we will type the mid formula equal to mid, begin the bracket, then choose the text from where you want to get the middle characters, which is the email ID. So we select that, semicolon, then you have to give the start number. So for that we can count where K comes. So it comes after 5 characters, so we can type 5 here, the start number is 5, and then semicolon, and then you have to give the number of characters that you want to show or see in the middle. So that also we are going to, since Kumar is of 5 characters, we will ask for 5 characters, and we'll type 5 here, end the bracket or close the bracket, and press enter. When you press enter, you see that it shows KUMA. This is happening because actually K is the 6th character, so we should have shown the start as 6. So we can go to the formula bar and use and edit. Instead of 5, let's say 6 is the start number, and then everything else is the same. When you press enter, you see Kumar gets entered here. So this is how you will use the mid formula. Now show how you can find the position of any one letter from a cell. Watch the video in case of a problem. Let us now watch this video and see how we can find the position of any particular text from a given cell. So we will be using the find formula. So we write the title here, find, and then we apply the formula. That will be equal to, then find, begin the bracket, and then you have to tell the text that you want to find, the text or the symbol that you want to find. So you have to put that in inverted commas. So if we want to find the @ symbol in this email ID, we will put the @ symbol in inverted commas. Put a semicolon and then select the text from where you want to find this symbol. That's the email ID. So we select that email ID, semicolon, and then position is 1, the first position. And then we close the bracket, press enter, and you can see that it shows you that the @ symbol in this email ID is at the 11th position. If you want to find for the other email IDs also, you can just simply drag this formula downwards and you will get the position for the @ symbol in the other email IDs also. This is how you will use find to find the position of any text or symbol in your cell content. Now, go ahead and type the email ID being shown to you in a column like rakesh.suri@computershiksha.org. Now, from this email ID, show how you will extract just the word Rakesh. If you face a problem, then watch the video. Next, let us watch this video now and see how we can use the left and find formula to find the exact first name from an email ID. For this, we are typing an email ID, which is rakesh.suri@computershiksha.org. You can also watch in the video and type out an email ID or type this email ID and practice what we are doing together. We can increase the width of this column a little bit so that the email ID fits in properly. Now we want to find from the left side the first name appearing in this email ID. So for that we will use the left formula. So we will write or we will key in the left formula, which is equal to, then we have to type left, equal to left, begin the bracket, then it says from which, what text, so we want it from the email ID, so we select that text or the cell, which is B8 cell, and then semicolon, and then we have to find the number till where we want to find, how many characters we want to find. So instead of giving a number, we are using the find formula because we want to find the number of the dot which is appearing in this email ID. So we write find, begin the bracket, and within inverted commas, we tell it to find the dot. So we key in the dot within inverted commas, then a semicolon, and then you have to select the text, which is the email ID. So we select that. And next you have to give the position after the semicolon. Or even if we don't give here, we can just close the bracket. And then since we want the name, first name, which is appearing before the dot, so if we are finding the dot, we'll do a -1. And then close the bracket for the left formula. And when you press enter, you will see that it shows you the first name, Rakesh, from this email ID. So what we have done is we have used the left formula and the find formula to find the first name from an email ID such that it is the name which appears before the dot. So this is something that you should practice so that you can become an expert at using the left formula and the find formula. Show how from this email ID you will extract only the word Suri. Again, in case of a problem, watch the video. Let us watch this video now and see how we can use the mid formula to find some text, any text from the middle of a cell. So if you have an email ID and like rakesh.suri@computershiksha.org, and if we want to find only the word Suri, we will use the mid formula for this. So we'll type equal to mid, begin the bracket, then select the text from where you want to find this. So that's the email ID, which is in B8 cell. So we select that, then semicolon, then we have to give the start number from where to start. So we can, instead of giving a start number, we'll use find the dot in this from where it has to start. So we'll find the dot and then we'll minus one because we want to find plus one because we want to find after the dot. So we say find begin bracket and within inverted commas we give a dot, then a semicolon, then you have to select the text again, which is the email ID or the B8 cell. So we key in that or select that, close the bracket. Then since the word Suri appears after the dot, so we will say plus one, which means from that number, start from after that dot plus one. And then we have to give a number. So we have to once again find, what we want to find now is the at the rate symbol. So we have to go from the dot till at the rate symbol. So we'll once again use find formula for this. Find within brackets and within inverted commas, we type at the rate. Then we select the text, which is the email ID itself. Close, put a semicolon again. Since there is another dot here, we will have to find that also. After computer shiksha, there is another dot. So we once again find, begin the bracket, select the text, which is the, select the dot that you want to find. So we put it in inverted commas, put a semicolon, then select the text, which is the email ID. Close the bracket for this find and one more close the bracket for the earlier find. Remember, this is a find within a find. Then we need to do minus another find we will do. So we'll write find minus find, begin the bracket, and within inverted commas, we'll put what we want to find, which is the dot again. So within inverted commas, then a semicolon, then select the text from where you have to find it. So that's the email ID. So once again, B8 cell. B8 cell, close the bracket, and then minus one because we want to find before the dot, and then close the bracket for the mid formula. Now when you press enter, you will see that the word Suri gets shown to you, which is what you wanted. So this is a slightly difficult formula, but you should note it down and try and see how it is used. We use mid because we want to find something from the middle of this email ID. Within bracket, we first type in the text, which is B8, then we find the dot by using the find formula, dot B8 plus 1 because we want to find after the dot, and then find again the at the rate symbol because still the at the rate symbol we are wanting to find, and so on. So try and use this formula again and again, practice it so that you become perfect in finding any text from the middle of a cell using the mid formula. Show how you will extract the words computer shiksha from this ID. Watch the video. Again, show how you will extract only the word ORG. Let us watch this video and see how we can find the word computer shiksha from this email ID, rakesh.suri@computershiksha.org. So as you already know, we will be using the mid formula and the find formula. So we type equal to mid, begin bracket. Then you need to select the text from where you want to find your text. And that is the email ID. So we select that email ID, which is at B8 cell. So we will take our cursor there and select that. Put a semicolon, and then you have to give the start number from where you want to start finding the text. So we want to start after at the rate. So for this, we will use the find formula. So we type find, begin bracket, and then we put at the rate symbol within inverted commas, because that is what we want to find. Put a semicolon. And where is this, in which text? It's in the email ID. So we will select that cell B8. Close the bracket. And since we want to find after the at the rate symbol, so we will say +1, which means start after at the rate symbol. Next, put a semicolon again. And once again, we'll have to find, because we need to find till the dot. So we say find, begin the bracket, put the dot between inverted commas, put a semicolon, and select the text from where you're going to find this dot, which is again the email ID or the B8 cell in this case. So we select that. So essentially, we are trying to find the words or the text written between the at the rate symbol and the second dot in this email ID. Then we put a semicolon again, and we will have to use find again. So find again, we'll have to find the at the rate symbol. So find begin bracket, and within inverted commas, the at the rate symbol, semicolon. And again, from which text you are finding, it is the B8 cell. So we select that. Close this bracket. And also close the previous find. So you will have to close it with double brackets. Now still we are working on the mid formula. And then we say minus find. One more time we need to use the find formula. Begin the bracket. And we're looking for the at the rate symbol. So we put the at the rate symbol within inverted commas, put a semicolon, again select the text from where you are finding, which is B8, the email ID, close the bracket, and -1, because we want to find from till 1 before the dot. So we close that, and then when we press enter, you will find whatever is written between at the rate and the second dot in the email ID will be shown to you, which is computer shiksha, as you can see in the video. Practice this usage, because it's a lengthy formula, but you now understand the concept and you can easily use mid and find to find the text from any cell or any email ID. Again, show how you will extract only the word ORG. Watch the video and see how this is done. Let us watch this video now and see how we can find the last words of this email ID, which is ORG. So we will use the write formula and the find formula for this. So we type equal to write, begin bracket, select the text, which is the email ID. So we select the B8 cell and then put a semicolon, and then instead of the number, to find the number, we are going to use, first we are going to use the length formula. We want to know how long is the length of this email ID. So we find we type LEN for length formula, select the text, which is the email ID itself, which is B8, close the bracket, and then we have to minus, and now we have to minus till the dot is there. So we have to use find to find where the dot is placed. Find begin bracket, then within inverted commas we'll put the dot, semicolon, and then select the text, which is the email ID itself, which is B8 cell. So we select that, and till where we since there are two dots here, so we have to look for the dot which is after the at the rate symbol. So to do this, we will once again use the formula. So after saying find dot B8, we once again use semicolon and then find, and within bracket we type the at the rate symbol within inverted commas, select the text, which is B8 again, because we are finding from the email ID. So we are trying to say after the at the rate symbol. So after this we put close the brackets, because three open brackets were used, so we close it with three close brackets, and when you press enter, you will find that .org, only .org is written. So you can see this formula, right? Then we select the cell where from we want to find, we calculate the length, and from the length we minus where the dot is, and after the dot we want, but this dot also we have to define that it should be after the at the rate symbol. So this is how you will use the write formula and the find formula and the length formula to find these last three characters on the right side of the cell. Now show how you will add two different names in one cell. You may want to watch the video if you have a doubt. Let us watch this video and learn how we can join two different names or two different texts from two cells. So for instance, you have Rakesh and Suri in two different cells. If we want to join it, we will use the concatenate formula. For this, we type equal to, then the word concatenate, which means to join. Concatenate. After that, begin the bracket and select the first text, which is Rakesh. So we select that, put a semicolon, and select the second text, which is Suri. We select that, close the bracket, and press enter. And you will see Rakesh, Suri coming in the same cell. So this way you can use the concatenate formula. Now show how you can replace some letters in a word. For example, in Ram, instead of AM, you need to get AMA using the substitute formula. Watch the video and learn how this is done. Watch the video to clear any doubts you may have. Watch this video now and see how you can use the substitute formula to substitute any text in a given cell with some other text. So for this, if you want to substitute the word Ram with some other word, let's first type that word. So we are typing R-A-A-M, Ram, and then we use the substitute formula. So we type equal to substitute equal to, and then the word substitute, which means to exchange or to replace, begin the bracket, and then you first have to select the text in which you want to make some change. So we select this entire cell here where Ram is written, put a semicolon, then within inverted commas you have to write the text that you want to replace. So we want to replace the entire word RAAM. So we type that in inverted commas, semicolon, and then type the new text that you want in place of this text. Occurrence is once. So we type 1 after a semicolon, close the bracket, press enter, and you can see instead of RAM, now only AMA is being shown. So this is how you will use the substitute formula. Now show how you will count the name in any cell to find out how many characters are there in it. Again, learn from the video if there is a doubt. Let us watch this video now and see how we can find the number of characters in a cell, for instance, in an email ID. So if you want to find in this email ID rakesh.suri@computershiksha.org, how many characters are there? We will use the length formula for this. So let's type the title as LEN for length, and then we will use the length formula to find the number of characters in this cell. For that, we will use equal to LEN, begin bracket, and then select the text. So select this email ID, which is B8 cell, close the bracket, press enter, and you will see that it shows that there are 31 characters in this email ID. If you count the characters in the email ID, you will find that there are 31 characters in this email ID. This is how you can use length formula to find the number of characters in any given cell in your Calc sheet. Till now, all of you have practiced using the formulas. Now, you will practice the use of the tools Mino options. Type some numbers in your cells like 50, 200, 100, and then show how you can make this total become 500 using an option of the tools Mino. If you have a doubt about this, do watch the video. Watch this video and see how we can use the Goal Seek option from the tools Mino to get a target value for a given sum of numbers. So for this, we are given some numbers like 50, 200. We are just typing those numbers, 50, 200 and 100. And we first find the sum of these numbers. To find the sum, or to add these numbers, we can directly use the sum formula. So we say equal to SUM, begin bracket, and then select all these three numbers, close the bracket, and you get the sum of these three numbers as being equal to 350. Now, if instead of 350, we want the sum to be 500, so our target value, which we are typing here, is 500. So we first select the 350, which is the target cell. Then we go to the tools Mino, click there and click on Goal Seek option. In the Goal Seek option, the formula cell, which is the sum total cell, is already selected. Target value, we type 500, and we can select one of these cells to be the variable cell. So we select the 100 as being the variable cell, click on OK, and you see that the Goal Seek says that if this becomes 250, 100 becomes 250, such that the total sum becomes 500 instead of 350. So the target cell now has, target has been achieved. Now apply scenario on any column of the names for which should be update 1. Now apply scenario on any column the name for which should be update 1. Next, change the value of the cells of the same column and then apply scenario again on the same and name it as update 2. And then also say how you will be able to view both these scenarios. Watch the video to learn more about this aspect. Let us watch this video now and see how we can apply scenarios on a set of data. So for that, we first have selected some numbers from this sheet, 50 to 100 to 50. We go to sheet 2 and paste this data here, 50 to 100 to 50. Now if we want to apply a scenario on this, we will select this data, go to the tools menu and select scenario. From this box, you can first give the name for this scenario. So we delete whatever is written there and then we call it update 1. Click on OK and you will see that a border gets applied on this and also a drop down button is there. So a scenario has been applied on this. You can see when you click on the drop down button, it shows you update 1 is the scenario. Now if you want to change the data or apply a different scenario, we will select this once again. Again, apply a scenario by going to Tools, selecting scenario. And now we, from the box that opens, let's give the name update 2 for this. So we give update 2, click on OK. And you can see that a second scenario has been applied on this portion. Now if we want to change these numbers, for instance, instead of 50, we type something else like A. Instead of 200, we type B. Instead of 250, we type C. So now there are two scenarios. If we click on the drop-down button, you can see update 1, update 2. Update 1 shows you the numbers. Update 2 shows you the text ABC. So this is how you can apply different scenarios on your set of data. Now, key in the values in two columns, 50, 75, 100, 125, 150, 200, the total of which is 700. Now, use an option which will help you make this a total of 1000 for these 5 values. In case you have a doubt, watch the video. Let us watch this video and see how we can use the solver option of the tools menu to get the sum to be equal to a target value for any given numbers. So we are first typing some numbers here, 50, 75, 100. And then in the next row, we have typed 125, 150, and 200. So let's first get the sum of these numbers. We can use the sum formula. So we say equal to sum, begin bracket, and then we choose the first set of numbers, put a semicolon and choose the second set of numbers, close the bracket, and the sum formula will give us the sum for this when we press enter and we get 700. So now we want to make this sum to be equal to the target value of 1000. So we select the sum number or the sum cell and then we go to the tools menu. We want to do this by changing one or more of these variable numbers. From the tools menu, select the solver option. The box opens and in this, the target cell is already defined where we have done the sum. There are three options here, minimum, maximum, value of. So in the value of, we type the target value, which is 1000. And we also want to tell the solver which cells you can change. So by changing the cells and we select the 50 and 75 cell. If we click on solve, you notice that the target value of 1000 is achieved. We click on keep result and you can see that it has changed the two cell values, one has become 425, the other has become 0, such that the total sum value is equal to the target of 1000. Next, show how you can merge your document with another document. Watch the video if you are not clear about how this is done. Watch this video now to see how we can merge two documents. Merge our Calc sheet data with some other document which is already on our computer. So for this, we will take our pointer to the tools menu and select the merge document option. When you select the merge document option, it opens a location box from where you can insert some document. For instance, in this, the Calc 8 document is there. We click on open, and this way a box opens which says accept or reject the changes. So here there's a list or which you can accept or reject. Also a filter tab is there. So if you want, you can accept or reject these to merge with your document. We can close this. So this is how you can use the merge document option. Next, show how you will apply a password onto your sheet or document. In case of a doubt, watch the video. Watch this video and understand how we can use a password to protect any sheet or document of ours. So if you want to protect this particular sheet, we will go to the tools menu and select the protect document option. And from this, we can select the sheet because we want to select protect the sheet. You can apply a password, confirm this password and click on OK in the protect sheet box. Then the sheet becomes protected. Now, if you want to make any changes or make any edit on this sheet, you will see a message saying that these are protected cells. So you can't make any changes because your sheet has been protected with a password. Since today's class ends here, save your file and close it and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class, all of you practice using options of the tools menu like Goal Seek, Scenario, Solver, etc. You could also practice the use of some of the formulas like left, right, mid, find, trim, etc. Computer Shiksha is supported by, thank you.